Before anything, a little backstory. I was 10 at the time and was visiting my hometown, Ecuador, for the summer. At the time, I knew just about everyone in my small little town, Alausi, and so did my parents, which is why they let me go on my own that day. Anyways, here's my encounter. Back when I was 10 years old, my family decided to take a visit to my hometown of Ecuador. We went for the summer and planned out just about our whole stay. One day, my mom and dad were getting ready to go to a wedding and I was in the house with them. My big sister went over to a friend's house and my other relatives had already left for the wedding. I was supposed to stay at home, alone for the duration, but I saw that it was a beautiful day out and decided to ask my mom and dad to go to a park that was no more than 2 blocks away. They were reluctant at first, stating that there would be nobody to take care of me, but I argued that it was a beautiful day out and there is no way that the park would be empty. They kept getting dressed as I kept on arguing until they finally gave in. They said that I can go to the park as long as I was back before dark. I agreed and ran outside to head for the park. It took me no more than 10 minutes to get there and I was ready to make new friends and play around. But, oddly enough, there was nobody else in the park. It looked abandoned, which was weird seeing how this was one of 2 parks in the whole city. It should have been packed, but I paid no mind to it. I believe I ran over to a swing set or slide. It was 12 years ago, I can't remember, and played around. As I played, I suddenly heard a voice from the distance. A clown was on the other side of a gate and motioning for me to get closer. Behind him was a white van, which I had noticed before but just thought it was a delivery truck of sorts. I slowly started walking towards the clown and stopped a good distance away from him. He asked me in Spanish, "Hey kid, do you like clowns?" I nodded no to him and he gave me that clown frown and then said, "Well then let me see if I can change that." He opened up his car and by looking inside I saw there was only 2 boxes. Though I wasn't sure was they were filled with, and that was it. No seats, no posters, just those 2 boxes and then complete emptiness. Being a child, I still paid no mind to it and watched as he pulled out a deflated balloon. He wrapped his lips around the end and blew till the balloon was fully inflated. He tied the end and started to form the balloon into a balloon animal of a dog. He showed it to me and I smiled. He then motioned me to come closer, to which I complied. He handed the balloon to me and said, "Do you like?" I nodded yes this time and gave him a little smile. He then grinned in the creepiest way possible. The grin was so creepy that even as a kid I knew to back away a bit. The clown then said that if I wanted to see the rest of his tricks I would have to get into the truck. I told him that the exit was on the other side of the park and I wouldn't be able to climb the small gate. He then said the few words that haunt me to this day. "Get a little closer and I'll carry you over. Then we can have loads of fun in my truck, come on kid." While saying this, he still had that creepy grin plastered across his face. I merely backed away and told him, "No, it's okay, sir." His grin turned into anger as though he was annoyed at this. He placed his hands on his hips and said to me, "Aw, but we're going to have so much fun." Right when he said that, I heard a voice on the other side of the park yelling, "Son, son, I'm here to pick you up." I turned and saw a man that I recognized as a local neighbor. He was not my real father, obviously, but the little me knew to run over to him. I said nothing to the clown. I just ran to man and gave him a hug. The man waved to the clown and said, "Thanks for keeping my kid entertained," to which the clown replied, "No problem." As we turned around, I was able to hear this man murmur, "Sick fuck." I looked at him and asked, "Sir, what exactly is going on?" He gave a sigh and explained everything. As it turns out, that was no real clown. He was a man that had been kidnapping kids across all of Ecuador. He would lure kids with the clown costume and take them away to God knows what place. The people of my town had a feeling he was coming to our town, which was why the whole park was deserted. He said that he was walking by when he noticed that I was talking to the clown and ran over to basically save me. As he told me this, he also dialed for the police to report the incident. We had finally arrived at my house and this man said, "Be careful with who you talk to, son. Not everyone is who they seem." I gave him one final hug and gave him a thanks for saving me from that sick fuck. He gave me a rub on the head and said, "It's okay, my boy, now hurry on in, I have my own things to worry about." I nodded and ran in the house. Nobody was there, and by the time they had returned, I had decided not to tell anyone since I knew they'd flip the fuck out. It took a while to forget about the whole incident, especially with those words that kept reminding me of him, but I soon forgot till I came across this page and memories of that clown flooded my head. I'm not quite sure what happened to the sicko, but hopefully he is now behind bars, hopefully. So to that creepy clown from long ago.
Ha ha ha.